Ireland's fair city, where the girls are so pretty. I first set my eyes on sweet Mary Malone. Where she wheels her wheel barrow, the streets far and narrow. Was a fishmonger, sure was no wonder, for so were her father and mother before. Heard about in their barrow, the streets broad and narrow, by cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, by cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh, slatter. Died of a fever, and no one could save her, and that was the end of sweet Molly Malone. Now a ghost beats her barrow, the streets broad and narrow, by cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, by cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh. There's one fair county in Ireland, with memory so glorious and grand, where nature has lavished his bounty, is the orchard of Erin's green land. I love its cathedrals and cities, once founded by Patrick Tuttler, and it bears in the heart of its bosom the ashes of Brian Carew. It's my own Irish home, far across the foam. Although I'm often left it in foreign lands to roam, no matter where I wander, the city is at home in old Ireland. Where? In the county of Armagh. I travel three parts of the county, from Newport for to Crossmaden, back around by the gap of Mount Narris, and home by black waters again, where the girls are so gay and so hearty, none fairer in Erin Gomrah. And where are the boys that can hurt them, like the boys from the county Armagh? It's my own Irish home, hello Francis, far across the foam. Although I've often left it in foreign lands to roam, no matter where I wander, the cities near or far, from my heart is at home in old Ireland, in the county of Armagh. Yes, the heart is at home in old Ireland, in the county of Armagh.
Night when I was small, Saturday night was the best night of all. Stirring the jelly and steeping the peas, we all had our own jobs as busy as bees. My job was polishing shoes nice and bright. Woo! My sister would iron the shirt oh so white. The babby was sleeping as quiet as a mouse. And Radio Erin was playing Kelly House. Oh, Saturday night when I was small, Saturday night was the best night of all. Stirring the jelly and steeping the peas, We all had our own jobs as busy as bees. Then Mammy would bring in the old chain bat and put it in front of the fire on the mat. She'd fill it up with water so hot, with saucepans and kettles and the old skillet pot. Oh, Saturday night when I was small, Saturday night was the best night of all. Stirring the jelly and steeping the peas, we all had our own jobs as busy as bees. Then Mammy would wash all our hair and our ears, soap in our eyes, sure there'd be so much tears. She'd dry us all and our hair she would brush, and into the bed then as snug as a thrush. Oh, Saturday night when I was small, Saturday night was the best night of all. Stirring the jelly and steeping the peas, we all had our own jobs as busy as bees. Then we'd all say the rosary down there on our knees. Was a merry old soul, and a merry old soul was he. He called for his wife in the middle of the night, and he called for his piper's tree. Now every piper has a fine fiddle, and a very fine fiddle has he. So why don't you fiddle while you can, said the fiddler, jolly fine men are we. There's no one here who can drink their beer like the men from Boherby. Now old King Cole was a merry old soul, and a merry old soul was he. He called for his wife in the middle of the night, and he called for his painter's dream. Now every painter has a fine brush, and a very fine brush is he. So why don't you slap it up and down, said the painter. Fiddle while you can, said the fiddler, jolly fine men are we. There's no one here who can drink their beer like the men from Boherby. Now old King Cole was a merry old soul, and a merry old soul was he. He called for his wife in the middle of the night, and he called for his tailor green. Now every tailor has a fine needle, and a very fine needle has he. So why don't you shove it in and out, said the tailor. Snap it up and down, said the painter. Fiddle while you can, said the fiddler. Jolly fine men are we. There's no one here who can drink their beer like the men from Boherby. Now old King Cole was a merry old soul, and a merry old soul was he. He called for his wife in the middle of the night, and he called for his jugglers three. Now every juggler has fine balls, and very fine balls has he. So why don't you throw your balls in the air, said the juggler. Shove it in and out, said the tailor. Snap it up and down, said the painter. Fiddle while you can, said the fiddler. Jolly fine men are we. There's no one here who can drink their beer like the men from Boherby. Now old King Cole was a merry old soul, and a merry old soul was he. He called for his wife in the middle of the night, and he called for his butcher's three. Now every butcher has a fine chopper, and a very fine chopper has he. So why don't you put it on the block, chop it out, said the butcher. Throw your balls in the air, said the juggler. Chope it in and out, said the tailor. Chop it up and down, said the painter. Fiddle while you can, said the fiddler. Jolly fine men are we. There's no one here who can drink their beer like the men from Boherby.
Her poop.
the cowboy who saddled the pony. Now rides through the dark night alone. Ay, 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 ay. Her parents were rich escondieros, and I was just one of the hands who herded her 10,000 cattle on 10,000 acres of land. But I was a very poor cowboy, and I lived in a world far apart. So how could I tell her I loved her and speak of loving my heart?
Trying a whole coat for. Right, lads, I'll tell you about a neighbour of my own. Tom Maloney was his name. Oh, he was a great footballer in his day, but he spent all his time running after the football. Didn't you forget to run after him? Before he knew it, the night came on him, he was left all alone and lonesome. The wind coming at him from every direction. And do you know now, his looks might be an issue, but his cramery check, I'm telling you, would be a distinct advantage. And as well as that, he's a good schnaid house with a bit of land with it. And as well, wanted the finest blacksmith in the seven parishes round. But was a well-known fact, Tom knocked more smacks off one shoe and an anvil than he ever did off a woman. He was like herself now. He never got to the giggle bend in his life. You know where the giggle bend is, don't you? What is that bare bit of flesh where the stocking ends and before the knickers begin? Because men say if they get that far, they're laughing. When who should come home from America? Yes, every tie brushes up something. And who should come home from America, the time I talk about only Nelly Quaid's daughter caught with a new coat, a new hat and a handbag, upon my soul, was the size of a horse's collar. She had two big lavericks of suitcases full of silken slips, knickers and all other sorts of finery. She'd all the girls at home driven in, cracked with envy. They had no silken finery next to their skin, not at all. Only old gibbles down to their knees tied with hemp and cart. And knickers made out of sunrise flower bags that would kill a bad tart a mile away. Well, if the truth was known, cart needed a finery. They say fine feathers make fine birds. Now, I'll describe cart. She was like the sort of girl now that fell off the ugly tree and hit every branch coming down. She, if you see the teeth she had in the front of her mouth, she had the unique quality now of being able to kiss a man and pluck his eyebrows at the same time. I tell you, she nearly ate an apple through a letterbox. When an account of matrimony was right anywhere, and she agreed to marry Tom. No, do you know now, the day you'd want everything to go right for you? Isn't that the day that everything would go against you? And poor old Tom, that mum, he was in an awful footer-fatter around trying to get everything done. And you see, he was late putting on his good new suit, you see, to go down to get married. When he hopped on the bike and he was going out the passage below, with whatever look he gave him, hadn't the cows broken into his cabbage. Nothing for his honey to go in and hunt him out. When he stood back like he always did, and he made a kind of a running jump off the tommy wire fence. But I suppose hampered with the tightness of the new suit, he didn't jump high enough. There he was, he was tangled. He couldn't let the drive. When he was in some predicament, but the neighbours had to extract him from the tub me wire fence. The doctor had to be called, and the doctor examined him, and the doctor said, you have to go into hospital. My boy said, I can't go into hospital. He said, I'm getting married this morning. He said, it's now or never for me. You see, he was like more of you out there now. He was an unclaimed treasure on the wrong side of 50. When the doctor said, you have to go in, your undercarriage, she said, is feels badly damaged. Especially the main shaft. Well, my wife said, look, doctor, he said, I thought you I'm getting married, so no way, he said, I can't go in. You're an old satchel there, he said, open it up and do the best you can for me. Well, against the doctor's better judgment, he opened up the bag and he set to work on my wife. And when he was finished, he got out a big roll of bandage and he rolled around and round and round. Well, now there wasn't that much to roll around. He get the gist. He did the best he could. And my boy went off and he got married. I tell you, he didn't dance much. The two knees were glued together by him. But being a strong man, he kept his predicament himself. But all good days have to come to an end. It was time for the children to slip away to the hammock in the room. How could he unveil it now? Well, in they go anyway, and she opens up her suitcase and she fudges around inside it, and out of her suitcase she takes out a snow white negligee. Have you ever seen what it is? Wouldn't you know the man that's been stout all his life? Well, she put it up against her like that, and she turned to my boy and she said, Snow White and never been touched, eh? Snow White and brand new, eh? She went off into a caboose in the corner and she got ready. And while she was gone, he chopped off as quick as he could down to the chassis. Into the bed he goes and he pulls the blankets up to his Adam's apple. When she came out from the cubby hall anyway, and she'd ear on her. And she came over and she looked at my boy in the bed again and she said, Snow White and never been touched. Snow White and brand new. Over she goes to the mirror. Snow White and never been touched. Snow White and brand new. She did a few more laps of the floor until my poor boy could take no more. He said, oh, certainly, oh, Snow White and brand new. Snow White never been touched. He went back to covers. He said, look at this girl. This wasn't even taken out of the wrapper yet.
Play there for years.
Hey, and my knees for sweet
and
my knees for sweet and the hour I am all along the high of the rock in the canal in the early morning. Oh, the screw he was falling, get off ye ballsy, and feed out yourself, and the owl triangle. One more jingle, triangle, all along the line of the when the screws were sleeping, ah, because he was weeping, as I let her weep, for my girl's salad, and the owl triangle, would go jingle, jangle. Yeah. dying women, and among them now, sure I would like to dwell. For the owl's triangle, would go jingle jangle, all along the bank of the river canal.
Yeah. Days they have told us we must yearn for liberty. Poor old Jessie Riley, she has taken to the stump. Poor old down, I see Riley, she will never give it up. She's off with party to the hop, where she goes in for another wee drop of the heart. And rowlin', I see Riley, walks along his favorite street in a nip that's dressed and there. And then the love for summer hill in a sea that people stare. Says just nearly half past one, this time I went for another little one. And rowlin', I see Riley, why Paddy? Poor old Dicey Riley, she has taken to the sub. Poor old Dicey Riley, she will never give it up. Up, up. Off his morning to the hop, where she goes in for another little drop of the heart. And the rolling Dicey Riley, she has a little sweet shop on the corner of the street. Every evening after school I go to wash her feet. She says it's nearly half past one, this time I went for another little one for the hack. And rowlin' Dicey Riley, poor old Dicey Riley, she has taken to the sun. Poor old Dicey Riley, she will never give it up. She's up before he could hop, where she goes in for another little drop of the heart. And rowlin' Dicey Riley, oh, poor old Dicey Riley, she has taken to the stuff. Poor old Dicey Riley, she will never give it up. Up, up, up each morning to the hop, where she goes in for another little drop of the heart. And rowlin' Dicey Riley. Thank you very much, thank you.
I said, you know, did he go and buy a bit of a nice underwear, and you know, to benefit himself as well, if you know what I mean. So he went into Sherry something Marie's shop up there, and he said, I want to get a bit of underwear. And she said to him, is it upper or lower? He said, upper. And she said, what do you want? Well, I want actually a bra, if you don't mind. And have you any idea of the size? He said, it's size 15. And she said, I don't understand size 15. Well, he said, let me try and explain to you. One of them fits into me hat, and it's 7.5, he said. And I suppose, stop you. This Kerry fella in Tralee, and he was heading to the dancing in his Shannon. But he filled up the car with petrol, but it broke down in across the just across the Kerry border, the Cork border.
Oh!
I hope you by ya. But anyway, he was hitching a lift and this Cork fella picked him up and he said, where are you from by? He said, I'm from Killarney, he said. Do you ever come to Cork? No, he said, it's not necessary. We have everything in Killarney, he said. Well, Cork is a very historic county, he said. Yoo-hoo! And they call it the Rebel County, he said. And I'll explain to you as we drive along the road. So he came to bail on a blow. And he said, this is where Michael Collins was killed. And the Kerry man said, right enough, it's a bad bind, all right, he said. But when he got to Innis Shannon, anyway, he was out dancing with this fabulous looking lady. And he wasn't the sharpest screwdriver in the toolbox, kind of left feet like myself. So he was walking on her toes and he was bumping her through this one and left, right and center. And she was getting very flushed, very red in the face. And I'd say she was going to walk off and leave him. And he said to her, excuse me, he said, I want you to know, he said, there's dancing in me blood. There was dancing in me grandfather, me grandmother, and all belonging to me, he said. You know, and there's dancing in my blood. And in a very soft voice, she said to him, you must have very poor circulation because it didn't get to your feet yet, she said. And lo and behold, anyway, this husband and wife, you see, and... Stop what you're doing, you're playing hell with me. And they were married for a good while, but they were having the station, and Tom was a devil for drinking. And then the priest called to Mary and he said, is everything okay Friday for the station? She says, Father, she said, I was just about to go down to see you. She said, Tom is drinking a lot, she said, and I'm afraid he'll ruin the station. And can you tell me what happens? All right, he goes to town for one pint, she said. He comes home at 9 or 10, and I bait the lard out of him. I have him bit black and blue, and it's no good. Jay, he said, Mary, you should try something else. Try a bit of kindness, a bit of romance. would you not consider buying a new negligee, you know, and have a sandwich ready for him when he come home? You know, because I know she said she'd try this night. Next thing she heard the key in the door and she had the beautiful negligee on with two big blue eyes, you know, looking out at him. He came in and she had a beautiful glass of whiskey for him. And she said, come on in, my darling. Jeez, your man took a look at her like he got a bit of a fright. Come in, my darling. Come into the sitting room. Have a glass of whiskey. Would you like a cup of tea and a sandwich? Or would you like another glass of whiskey? Jeez, he totally stuck back and when he took a look at her. Jeez, he said, ma'am, if it's all the same to you, I'll have another glass of whiskey because my one will bait the lard on me when I go home. She couldn't be up to them. High up or low down. There's no doubt about it. Will you go back to a bit of music? Oh, no, you're going for tea.
Another joke.
What?
Another joke.
Well, she was in the Yank came to Ireland, you see, one time. And he came to Ballinspittle, you see, and he was going down the road, you see, and he said, hello there, Paddy. He said to Pat, the cockman, how are you doing there, boy? He said, I'm from the United States of America. He said, I'm here on vacation. He said, do you ever go on vacation? She said, I don't have to go on vacation, he said. I'm a day from here, he said. And he said to your man, do you know anything about the States of America? What do you mean? Do you know anything about the States we have in America? I don't, he said, but I know. Do, re, mi, do. But he said, look, we have a lot of states in America, he said. I know that, he said, you have 49 or 52. Some of them you shouldn't have, he said. How many states have you in Ireland? He said, we have only one state, the same state I was in last night, the night before, and the same state I'll be in the morning, he said. You know what I mean? But he said, do you know anything about the dignitaries in Ireland, in America, in the United States? No, he said, have you heard of Barack Obama? No, he said, would that be the tanned lad that looked like he was in the bog all year? That's him, he said. And have you heard of Bob Hope? No, he said, have you heard of Johnny Cash? I walk the line. No, he said, who have you in Ireland? I'll tell you who we have in Ireland. We have Indy Kinney, we have no Hope, or we have no Cash either, he said. And just one to finish one. That's how many bells do you have in the
house? That's calling you to mess.
It's a sign, Kevin. It's a sign.
It's calling you to mess.
Well, if it tends to get too blue, those come on. It's a sensor.
Well, it's a bit like the two boys were outside the pub in the, how are you getting on? In Ennis one night. And the two lads were fairly well drunk and they were looking up at the moon. And Pat said to Tom, that's a funny yoke up there, he said. Is that the moon? I don't think it is, he said. I'm not sure what it is. So this other fella came along, and he wobbling, and he fairly well drunk. He said, would you be able to settle an argument? He said, what's that joke up there in the sky? And your man straightened the cap and took a look up at it. Jesse said, I haven't a clue. I'm not from round here at all, he said.
Hands together there for Kevin. Come on. Well done. Wonderful entertainer. Thank you.
In the town of Innes, going back a number of years ago, and he was working for the bishop. In actual fact, we met the bishop today, and Mary danced with him. And I said to him, in actual fact, he married his, how many Mary? 42 years ago, and I'm suffering since. Well, what about it? What's about 10 years? What does it mean? You put 10 years extra on my life anyway. But he was working for the bishop, but didn't he see an ad in the paper for a fairly high-profile job in Rome? But he applied for it and he got word. Out to Rome for an interview. And the cardinal said, we have 20 people in for the interview, you're the 15th. We're going to ask everybody the same three questions and then we'll decide. And he said to him, who was born in a stable? Jesus, man said, Red Rum. Now, wasn't a great answer. And he said, what do you know about Damascus? Well, he said, it kills 99% of all known germs, he said. And he said, what happened when the 12 apostles went to Mount Olive? He said, Pop, I bet the lard out of them. But these two lads were in a pub one evening, and they were having a pint, you see. And you'll have to read between the lines a small bit. And Pat said to Tom, will you have another pint? I didn't, I won't, he said. because he said, you're in bad humour, I am. Ah, he said, we got a summons to a wedding there, he said, and it's awful expensive. And sure, he said, to make it worse again, they're living with each other now, sleeping with each other long before ever they get married, he said. I suppose there, says Pat. Well, Pat said, I never slept with my wife before I got married. Did you, Tom? I don't know, he said, what was her maiden name, he said. When Pat got home, Mary, take down the, will you stop that old carry on? Tonight, when I'm up in the room, you'll have a pain everywhere. But I have more olive oil rubbed on you than Popeye. But anyway, when Tom got home, wasn't there an invite to a wedding? And Mary said, she said, this calls for Dublin, for a new outfit. She said, there's nothing in Innes or Limerick, she said. And you know the little female palm dog, she said, I have, that I go everywhere with, won't be allowed into the shops in Dublin. So you're coming with me tomorrow to mind the dog outside the shops. Well, I'm not going with you, he said. Hi, up. Well, she said, you're coming, and that's it. So he went reluctantly, so they got the train to Dublin anyway. And Tom was outside holding a little palm dog. Mary went into about 40 shops, not an outfit to be got. They got on the train coming home, and if Mary was over there, the dog was there, and Tom was over there. It was Channel 4, all picture, no sound, if you know what I mean. So the train stopped in Portlaoise, and this big yank got on. The train was full. And he came down along the train, and he looked at the dog, and he said, hey, lady, would you mind taking the dog off the seat? I had a bad day. You know nothing about a bad day, she said. I had a desperate day. Well, he said, I'll put my coat on the floor. He can sleep on it. He won't know that. She said, are you thick or something? You're not getting the seat. I paid for the seat for the dog. And with that, didn't the yank catch the little female dog with the two back legs, swung around in a circle, and fired him out the window. And Tom leapt up. He said, you're sick of me, you yank. You're driving the wrong side of the road. You hold a knife in the fork in the wrong hand, and you come to Dublin, and you throw the wrong bee off the train. But part two. The following morning, Mary got up and she went off to Inniscarthy down Joe's country. And the first shop she went into, she got a fantastic outfit. And she came home in the evening and she said to Tom, do you want to see me outfit? And didn't I don't? He said, I'm going to bed. Oh, shit. And he said, you'll be wearing it anyway, you're the best. So Tom went to bed, you see, and like all men when they go to bed, when they're in with the clothes off all the head, they're peeping out with one eye when they see the women undressing to see how the anthem changed like. And Mary said to Tom, she said, I know you're looking. What do you think of my outfit? Well, if you don't mind me saying so, he said, your backside looks as big as a three-ring cooker. Well, Mary was disgusted. Didn't she get into bed? And after about 10 minutes, Tom put his arms round her and he said, Mary, would there be any chance of a better? How's your father? No, Tom, she said, you listen here to me and you listen very carefully. I don't think, she said, there's any point in lighting a three-ring cooker for a cocktail sausage, she said. The audience, because no matter what group or no matter what band you have, if you haven't an audience, you have nothing. And it's a compliment and a credit to these people and to Cardia, who fed us free this evening. We're heading home, Eileen to Sligo, and I don't know where I'm going, to some hospital if they take me in. But good night, Iowa, and safe home. Happy days.
I'm sitting on that lifts of Moher, looking out to sea. The broad Atlantic swells below me, a bridge love between you and me. The pulp and flies above the skies, the seagulls fly through the air. They're calling us back from New York City, back home to my county up there. come back, sweet Annie, come back, or I will be there. We'll sing and we'll play in an old-fashioned way on the hillside of Sweet County Fair. I'll take your hand, we'll walk through the burn, in life's own sweet flowers so rare. The yellow echoes. That Queen Abbey and all the world, and once and where? How can it be? If you stay.
young. Lord, I'm on you. Lord, I'm on you. Come back. Come back, sweet honey. Come back, try when we dare. We'll sing and pretend in an old-fashioned way on the hillside of the county there. I'll take your hand. We'll walk through the burn. It lights the sweet flowers so rare. The yellow and the red, they go all in their head. We'll knock in the way their hair. We'll build a green navy and gold to the Sula, where holy men once held in prayer. Ah, but how can it be if you stay away, darling, from your home sweet beyond there? The dust and the cold of the city, where people pass by and don't care. There's a love and a welcome that's warm as the sunshine for you in the house beyond there. Come back, sweet honey, come back, try, we'll be there. We'll sing and we'll play in an old-fashioned way. On a hillside, a sweet mountain there. Come back, sweet honey. Come back, try, we'll be there. We'll sing and we'll play in an old-fashioned way. On a hillside, of sweet mountain there.
Thank you. We want the young lady down here.
I took a rose to Island Bridge. Was it raised by the fair? Walking by. Thank you.
Many tears while we all stop sorrow with the poor. There's a song that will linger forever in our ears. Oh, hard times come again no more. Sing with me, folks. Is a song the sign of the cabin door, oh, hard times come again. life away with a warm head whose bitter days roar. No, her voice would be merry, she's sighing all the day. Oh, hard times come again no more. It is a song, a sign of the weary. Hard times, hard times come again no more. And ye days you have lingered around my cabin door. That is wounded across the troubled wave. There's a wail that is heard upon the shore. There's a dirge that is murmured around my lonely grave. Oh, hard times come again no more. Is a song the sign of the down.
a little bit of fear let me down. A little bit of fear let me down. A little bit of fear let me down.
Good for life. Thank you.
I was a pretty little baby, my mama would rock me in a cradle in the mall. Cutting days back home. When I was a pretty little baby, my mama would rock me in a cradle in the mall. Cutting days back home. Oh, when them cotton balls get rotten, they don't feel very much cotton in them all. Cotton feels back home. It was down in Louisiana, just about a mile from Texas. In them all, cotton feels back home. It may seem a little bit funny, but we had not very much money. In them all, cotton feels back home. It may seem a little bit funny, but we haven't got very much money. In them all, cotton feels like home. Oh, when them cotton balls get rotten, they don't feel very much cotton. In them all, cotton feels like home. It was down in Louisiana, just about a mile from Texarkana. In them all, cotton feels like home. Down upon the Swanee River, oh, far, far away. There's where my heart is parting ever, and there's where the old folks stay. All up and down the old creation, oh, sadly I roam. And all for the old folks at home. All the world is sad and weary everywhere I roam. Oh, dark is how my heart grows weary. All for the old folks at home. Oh, the Captown ladies sing this song. Captown racetracks 5 miles long. Oh, do da day. Put my money on the bobtail light. Do da, do da. Put my money on the bobtail light. Don't be all day. Don't run all night. Don't run all day. Put my money on the bobtail light. Somebody bet on the bay. Big black pony and a big grey horse. Do da, do da. Race the track and ran the cross. Oh, do da day. Big black horse fell into a hole. Do da, do da. Couldn't reach the bottom with a 10-foot pole. Oh, do da day. Going to run all night. Going to run all day. Put my money in a bobtail light. Somebody bent on the bay. Going to run all night. Going to run all day. Bet my money in a bobtail night, somebody bet on the bay. When I was a pretty little baby, my mama would rock me in that cradle in the mall. Cotton feels like home. When I was a pretty little baby, my mama would rock me in that cradle in the mall. Cotton feels like home. When them cotton balls get rotten, they don't yield very much cotton. The mall cotton feels like home. It was down in Louisiana, just on my Kentucky counter. In the mall cotton feels like home. In the mall cotton feels like home.
Thank you, and thank you to the dancers. Wonderful, well done.
Farewell to you, my own true love. I am gone. I am bound for California, and I won't return till some fine day. So very well, my own true love, and when I return, united we will be. It's not the leaving of Liverpool that pays me, but my darling, when I think of thee. I have sailed on the Yankee train.
Alfred is her name. And Burgess is a captain of her, and to say that she's a floating hulk. Thought very well my own true love, and when I return united we will be. It's not the leaving of Liverpool that fails me, but my darling, when I think of thee. Oh, the ship is on the harbour launch, and I know it will remain. For I know it'll be a long, long time before I see you again. So fare thee well, my own true love, and when I return, united we will be. It's not to leave and not to your full and crazy, but my darling, when I think of thee. So fare thee well, my own true love, and when I return, united we will be. It's not to leave and not to your full and crazy, but my darling, when I think of thee. Is not the fear of you, but my darling, when I think of thee.
Thank you.
Now when I go home, I'm going to be alone. Put my hair through my coat, and that's all right when I go home. She is innocent, she is free. Tell me, who is she? I tell me, ma, when I go home, why must I keep her alone? Pull my hair, throw my coat, and that's all right, and I go home. She is handsome, she is pretty, she is a girl of the party. She is a girl of the one, two, three. Please, don't you tell me, who is she? Albert Mooney says he loves her, all the ways I'm fighting for. Rapping at the door and the ringing the bell, it's in all my true love by you. Out she comes as white as snow, rings on her fingers, bells on her toes. Oh, Johnny Murray says she'll die if she doesn't get the fella with her open eye. And tell me, ah, I go home, why don't lady girls alone? Pull my hair, stole my comb, and that's all right, I go home. She's handsome, she is pretty, she is a girl of Belfast City. She is a coach, you know, one, two, three, please don't tell me who is she.
Or
a boy. Oh, a terror to Australia was the wild colonial boy. One morning on that ferry, as Jack he rode along, a listening to a mockingbird, a singing a cheerful song. Up step three rebel troopers, Kelly, Davis and Fitzroy. For they all set out to capture him, that wild colonial boy. Surrender now, Jack Dogan, for you are a plundering son. Surrender in the Queen's high name, for you know your race is run. Jack pulled a pistol from his side, and he aimed them at Fitzroy. I fight, but not surrender, says the wild colonial boy. He fired a shot at Kelly now, which brought him to the ground. Turning round to Davis, he received a fatal wound. A bullet pierced that brave young heart from the pistol of Fitzroy. And that was how they captured him, the wild colonial boy. Yes, that was how they captured him, the wild colonial boy. My love, by the gasworks wall, dream the dream by the old canal. I kiss my girl by the factory wall. Dirty old town, dirty old town. Clouds are drifting across the moon. Cats are prowling underneath. Brings a girl from the streets at night. Dirty old town, dirty old town. Oh, oh. I met my love on the gasworks wall. Dreamed a dream by the old canal. I kissed my girl by the factory wall. Dirty old town, dirty old town. I heard a siren from the docks. Saw a train set the night on fire. I felt this break of a smoky wind. Dirty old town, dirty old town. I met my love by the gasworks wall. Dreamed a dream by the old canal. I kissed my girl by the factory wall. Dirty old town, dirty old town. I phoned to buy me a picture pack. Shining steel tempered in the fire. I'll chop you down like an old oak tree. Dirty old town.
Lose what's to lose, only for a summer. With your long barrel gun. Say what wind from the south brings a messenger. With the same mother, daughter, for a dream. Goodly youth, goodly youth, shall I bring you forth.
Goodly youth, shall you hear far demand. For a boy's marching forth from the south to the north. Let boys take the boy's walking land.
Tell me who is the giant when the gopher to rise on the head of mine. 7 feet is his height on some inches, and he looks like a being in mine.
Oh, my boys, that's the pride of the bold chandelier. Once the greatest hero is a man. Set your beavers aloft and your three ring two for John Kelly, the boy from Killam.
And a score at these of flames and no expert has won. And some bubble the barrel we'll on the hill of the town we planted that was blanchered again with blood.
All of four men and Benjamin the march.
But the foremost of all in the green gaffer
was George Kelly, the boy from Killam.
Mother Goose, son of freedom, grew dark in headrest, and his sabre's flames red. And oh, experts should make it on high or her cross, her heart pierced by traitors and knaves.
Glory on, glory on to the brave from the fight for the cause of long downtrodden man. Glory on to my men, sir, and darling, for this Kelly, the boy from Killam.
For this Kelly, the boy from Killam.
Oh,
the challenge of an ancient game brought glory, glory to your name. Though March winds blew, the crowd still came to watch you, gentle hero. In life's long march, you made us proud, and many's the voice from out the crowd called out your name aloud, aloud, and echo still resounding.
And Blackstairs' men who saw you then still speak of you in awe. On Cormann's Reen, where you have been, they tell of what they saw. We watched you on September fields, and lightning was the drive. You were the one, Cuchulain's son, in 1955.
The hand that held a stick of ash, and the man who led with style and dash, O'Carrick to who felt the crash, and Bennett's bridge and Thurles. And when in later life you beat the devil on that lonely street, you showed us how to take defeat with dignity and courage.
And Blackstairs' men who saw you then still speak of you in awe. On Cormann's Reen, where you have been, they tell of what they saw. We watched you on September fields, and lightning was the drive. You were the one.
one, Coos Holland's son, in 1955.
The last parade was sad and slow, and the last oration spoken low. And as on green fields long ago, the diamond stood beside you. All friends, they flanked you side by side, and the tears they shed were tears of pride. An ash tree toppled when you died, and scattered seeds at random.
And Blackstairs men who saw you then still speak of you in awe. On Cormans Green, where you have been, they tell of what they saw. We watched you on September fields, and lightning was the drive. You were the one, Cuchulain's son, in 1955. You were the one, Cuchulain's son, in 1955.
Thank you. Thank you for listening to us. It's all fun. Thank you for listening.
Got the place in the choir. Some sing low and some sing higher. Some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands, applause or anything you got. Now all God's creatures got the place in the choir. Some sing low and some sing higher. Some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands, applause or anything you got. Now the bass is the one at the bottom where the woodworm broke, and the hippopotamus is bone and groans in the big tattoo, and the owl cow just goes boo. The ducks and the cats go to take up the middle where the honeybee hums and the cricket fiddles, the jumpy brays and the pony nails, and the owl grey badgers sigh. Oh! All God's creatures got the bass in the choir, some singing low and some singing higher, some singing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands, all the money you got now. Just to the top with the little voice singing, and the melodies and the high notes ringing, and the hoot owl cries over everything, and the blackbird disagrees. Singing in the night time, singing in the day, and the little dog quacks when it's on its way. The otter hasn't got very much to say, and the hedgehog talks to itself. So, all God's creatures got a place in the choir. Some singing low and some singing higher. Some singing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands, applause, and the music got out. It's a simple song, little song, songs everywhere, by the ox and the fox and the grizzly bear, the donkey and the gator and the hawk above, the fly all weasel and the turtle dove. All God's creatures got a place in the choir. Some sing low and some sing higher. Some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands, applause or anything you got now. All God's creatures got a place in the choir. Some sing low and some sing higher. Some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands, applause or anything you got now.
Thank you.
One Monday morning, high upon the gallows tree, Kevin Barry gave his young life for the cause of liberty. Just a lad of 18 summers, yet there's no one can deny, as he walked to death at morning, proudly held his head on high. Just before he faced the hangman in his dreary prison cell, British soldiers tortured Barry just because he would not tell the names of his comrades and other things they
wish to know. Turn informer or we'll kill you. Kevin Barry answered no. Calmly standing to attention, he bade his last farewell to his broken heart and mother, who sad grief no one could tell. For the cause he proudly cherished, this sad parting had to be. Then to death walked softly smiling, that old Ireland might be free. Another martyr for old Ireland, another murder for the crown, whose brutal laws may kill the Irish, but will never keep our spirits down. Lads like Barry are no cowards, from the foe they will not fly. Lads like Barry will free Ireland, for her sake they'll live and die.
Thank you.
Road sharing of one road. We're on the road to God knows. We're on the one road, maybe the long road, but we're together now, who cares? North men, south men, comrades all, Dublin, Belfast, Cork and Donegal, we're on the one road, bring you along, singing a soldier's song. Though we have our troubles now and then, now is the time to make them up again. Irish handy how, and now is the time to get together. Now we're on the one road, sharing the one road, we're on the road to God knows where. We're on the one road, maybe the long road, but we're together now, who cares? The Northmen, Southmen, comrades all, Dublin, Belfast, Cork and Donegal, we're on the one road, bring you along, sing your soldier song. Tinker, tailor, every mother's son, rich man, poor man, shouldering his gun. Everybody standing now in line, all together now for our lang syne. We're on the one road, sharing the one load. We're on the road to God knows where. We're on the one road, maybe the long road, but we're together now, who cares? Northmen, Southmen, comrades all, Dublin, Belfast, Cork and Donegal, we're on the one road, swing along, singing a soldier's song. Keep right on till the end of the road, keep right on to the end. Though the road be long, may your heart be strong, keep right on round the bend. Though you're tired and weary, still journey on, till you come to your happy abode. Well, all your love you'll be dreaming of will be there at the end of the road. When my hood fire was in my blood, I dreamt of ancient freemen, of Greece and Rome who bravely stood, 300 men and freemen. And then I prayed I yet might receive our bread.
red in vain, and Ireland long a province be, a nation once again.
All together.
A nation once again.